What's up, guys? I'm Cousin Tino. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Welcome to these videos where we go behind the scenes and I give you some insight into some of my favorite tricks and the illusions kind of reveal behind the velvet curtain, so to speak. With that being said, if you haven't subscribed, do that right now. Turn on the notifications because the videos are coming to you every single week. We're working extremely hard to get these videos out to you, and we do appreciate your help and all of your support. So with that being said, let's get started. Okay, so we're going to take a look at the famous sawing in half illusion, originally created in 1912 by a magician named P.T. Selbert. Now, when he first performed the illusion, he used a man to saw in half, and the man was covered with these wooden crates or boxes. You could only really see the head and the feet. So for my very first television special, I wanted to pay tribute or homage to the classics of magic. And what's more synonymous with the art of magic than sawing a person in half? It's as synonymous as pulling a rabbit out of a hat. But we had to update it. So we were going to do it with clear Perspex boxes. You would see the volunteer or the assistant from start to finish, head to toe the entire time. Plus, we wanted it to be a random member of the audience. So what actually happens is the member comes up, I hypnotize them, I put them in a state of sleep, and then I saw them in half, put them back together, and then take them out of hypnosis. Now in this particular video, we've basically cut the hypnosis out, we jumped straight into the sawing in half, and it really is a favorite illusion of mine. If you think about it, in essence, the illusion, the concept behind sawing a person in half is quite grotesque. You're taking a blade or a saw and you're cutting the person in half and separating them and then hopefully putting them back together. So because of the nature of the effect, I wanted to make it more rock, more kind of grungy. So we're performing to a Marilyn Manson track called Personal Jesus, which I don't usually perform to commercial tracks. If I do, they need to be relevant to the actual effect. If I'm performing with lyrics, they need to make sense to me. I don't usually have lyrics in my music tracks. This one kind of makes sense, Personal Jesus. And I think the rock element behind it fits with the nature of the effect. I mean, it's not romantic, it's not slow. It's quite an aggressive piece. Therefore, the music needs to match it. If the music didn't match the aggressive nature, to me, it wouldn't make sense. And I think that's what makes a difference in the illusion. When you add the lighting, when you add the music, the choreography, when you blend all those together, you get a seamless performance. And I think it makes for a much better effect. And sometimes people don't even realize why, sometimes when they watch an illusion show, why some illusions look good and some illusions look great. And it comes down to the staging. It's like any film, it's like any musical, all those elements need to be working together to create a great performance. So right now, let's check out my version, Sawing in Half. Let's begin. Okay, Claire, need you to put your arm through the spot. Yeah, that's it, find that, yeah, excellent, fantastic. Good, you're doing really well.
So I'm explaining to her what she needs to do, put her arm through the box. You can see the boxes are clear. These are real reactions from audience members. This was shot live in one night. No retakes, it's a live show. Very difficult to perform a live show and film it at the same time and kind of blend the two together. Headstock goes on to keep her head locked in place and the footstock. And we pull these chains to create the effect as if we're locking her in place. Drag the apparatus forward. And here is the industrial buzzsaw. And I'm going to show that it is real, solid. All right, here we go. Turn the saw on. Real reactions, by the way. You can tell because the flashing of the lights on the stage match with the flashing of the lights on the audience members. There's no trick photography in here. As you can see, the pyrotechnics, the lighting, all quite aggressive. And split. shock. I love that. So Kelly's steady cam shot there. Showing that her feet are still moving. Alright, so we're now going to put her back together. Headstock comes off, footstock comes off. Top shot you can see from above. See straight through the boxes. Boxes come off, clear.
You're doing really well. Once you remove your arm, good stuff.
Poor girl, I was very sweaty. And I was sweating all over her as I kissed her forehead.
Coming up nice and gently, I've got you good. Just scoot up. Fantastic.
I'm going to bring her back now, out of the hypnosis.
That is good. Perfect. You're doing really well. Okay. Nicola, I'm going to bring you back and I'm going to count backwards from 4 to 1, okay? When we reach 1, you'll be wide awake. You'll be feeling absolutely fantastic. Okay, so 4. Start to feel your toes come awake. That's good. Your ankles, your knees, your waist, your neck, and your head. Good. 3. Just let yourself come out slowly. Good. Good. That's good. 2. Your eyelids are starting to open. Good. And 1. Wide awake. Feeling really good. Fantastic. Claire, hold my hand. Come with me. You've done an absolutely wonderful job. Please, come on. Give it up for Claire.
It kind of feels like you're really delusional because you can hear things, but you can't feel anything. I really don't know how to explain it. It's unbelievable.
So there you have it. Sawing a person in half. You'll notice that the lighting was blue to give a kind of cold effect, to give more of an industrial or kind of a sterilized effect. And of course the flames and the fire kind of contrast that, but make it quite aggressive. You know, a great piece to perform. Whenever I can perform this piece, I love to do it. People are fascinated with seeing a sawing in half, especially when it's done like that with clear perspex boxes. And it really is baffling. People always have their ideas and concepts of how it's done, but in essence, of course, it's an illusion, it's a trick. I'm not really sawing her in half. If I did, I'd be in prison for doing that. But with that being said, it's a great trick, it's a great effect, it's a great illusion, and when it's done properly, executed properly, it's a beautiful piece. Well guys, there you have it. Another little review or insight into one of my favorite tricks and illusions from my TV special back in 2012 for Channel 7. I hope you've enjoyed it. Until next time, thank you very much. Be safe and I'll see you all very soon.